Hello and welcome to another video for LimnoGlutenet. Today it's about SailfishOS. And well, I'm still doing that despite some other PinePhone YouTuber just published a video on that recently. So first let's choose a language. There are a bunch of languages available. I don't even know what these signs translate to. And let's just pick the US, and then accept that and use a license agreement, of course, without reading it, as you always do. Now, SailfishOS is a Linux, mobile Linux operating system, which likely has the longest heritage. Do you remember those Nokia devices in 2009, the N900, and then the N9 in, I think, 2010 or 11. That's where it's originating. And then Nokia got this new CEO, and that guy was like, well, you know, I worked at Microsoft before, let's stop those Linux OSs and use a great solution, Windows Phone 7. Sirius, I think, was the full name of that operating system, which never went anywhere. And yeah, that didn't play out well for Nokia, which is why they don't make phones anymore. There's HMD Global that licensed the Nokia brand, but well, that's just a brand licensing deal. So Yola, the company, was founded in 2011, and they published their first phone in 2013, and then in late 2014 they decided to make a tablet, and that thing almost sunk their ship. I have a Yola account, but I'm not going to do this right now because I don't want to sign on camera. So this is the most annoying part of SailfishOS, by the way. This is the gesture learning mode. And I've done this, I don't know, 25 times. Not really. But it's in the double digits for sure. I did this a bunch of times on the PinePhone and on other hardware previously that also had unofficial community ports like this device has, the PinePhone. And yeah, it's dreadful. I wish there was a way to skip this. And if you know a way to skip this, please comment or send me an email or whatever. Or hit me up on Twitter. You know, get in contact, please get in touch. So now I was going to tell you about the history of Yola, and I think I did a half good job there. The tablet almost sunk the company. Some people still weren't, to this day, aren't fully refunded. And of course, hold a grudge against Yola, the company, because of that, which is understandable. Although I think, you know, don't hold a grudge forever. It's not worth it. And that certainly slowed their progress, because they had to lay off a bunch of people and so on. But they're still alive and kicking. Their SailfishOS is the base for a Russian OS called, I think it's Aurora. And yeah, it's one of the few OSs that is not Android or iOS, and so there was one more device after the Yola tablet, that was the Yola C, which was a low-end phone. The original Yola phone called Yola had been a mid-range phone. And yeah, So they then went on to you can buy Yola, officially supported Yola, for a bunch of devices. Mainly these are Sony, mid-range Sony phones, and so if you want to run Selfish OS or Yola, there's a cheaper option than getting the PinePhone. Those, at least on German eBay, those Sony Xperia X, Sony Xperia XA2, and Sony Xperia 10 devices often get sold used for about 100 euros. So, yeah, that's really great. And then you can pay, I think it's like 50 bucks for official Yola support, which you can test out free for, I think, a month before. And then you have a Selfish X phone, and that is, I think, a pretty cool deal. You get Android support. It's on the XA2 and the 10, it's Android 8. So you can have apps and have some kind of official integration for those. This version I'm having a look here is the latest for the PinePhone as of early October. I checked yesterday again. I didn't check today. Maybe today there's already a new version to download, but this one was created on the 1st of October. And yes, so that's that. Hope that's my security code. Yeah. Now, as you can see, they have two browsers pre-installed on this community image, and that is Browser and WebKit. WebKit is based on WebKit, and the browser is based on Gecko, which is Firefox's engine. And this release here, because that's what I wanted to look at. I'm sorry, I'm a bit... my brain is a bit broken after a long workday. So let's see, Selfish OS updates. Yeah, but there was a version number. It's 3.3.0.16, and they have a newer version of their OS 3.4.22. in early access currently, which is supposedly bringing a newer Gecko engine, and that is a Gecko 52, which, as Gecko versions are the same as Firefox versions, is plenty old. Current Firefox is version 81. But let's just briefly go to this one site I like, and that is html5test.com, which is horrible and old, but lists a couple of supported browser features. It's so old it doesn't even have encryption. And I don't seem to have a working connection or what. Yeah. So let's test WebKit, which is based on Qt WebKit. And you know that the current Qt browsers are based on something newer, which is called Qt Web Engine, which is basically Chrome. And that's another point that is not so great about Selfish OS. It's stuck on Qt 5.6. Oh, and that is already Qt Web Engine, apparently, because it's imitating Chrome Dev 30. But Chrome 30, I don't know where Chrome is today, somewhere in the 80s, is also quite old. So modern browsers and modern websites can be an issue with Selfish OS. That said, this gesture-based navigation is pretty nice. And while bits of the OS are proprietary, it's specifically parts of this UI layer, which is really smooth. I mean, look at that. I will just pause and get my phone. Now I took a time machine and I'm magically a few days in the future. I didn't finish this video a long while ago, but I did not want to go through this funny tutorial you saw earlier again, so, and especially not so on video, so I just decided that I would keep the parts of that previous try to record this and not just, you know, start all over. Now, in the meantime, I did something like this. I hope you can see that. This is the WebCat browser. And these commands show how to upgrade Sailfish to the current release, because there is no build of this new release yet for the PinePhone. And actually, I don't think I even know when it would arrive. So I also installed a couple more apps. This here is another browser that is using that WebKit engine. Let me just briefly go to html5test.com while we hear the PinePhone hissing, which, by the way, it doesn't have to do, but I will show you that in a future video. And yeah, this also affects WebCat, that other browser we have here on the PinePhone. Since the upgrade, it's even it got a worse rendering engine apparently. I don't know how that happened, but it did. And the stock browser, which with this new 3.4.0.24 release, which has a Finnish name I won't even try to pronounce, has apparently some problems rendering on the PinePhone, because the PinePhone is not using Helium or Libhybris or whatever else it is that normal, quote-unquote normal Sailfish OS devices use, which are based on Android phones. This is a mainline phone, and thus it seems to have some graphical issues that it doesn't have otherwise. It's in a way maybe similar to the situation with UbiPorts, so, or Ubuntu Touch. And this also applies to Flatpaks. I installed, okay, I may have done something wrong here, that's also a possibility. I installed this Flatpak runner and Anglefish, that Plasma mobile browser I like a lot, to have a more modern browser, but it doesn't seem to be starting, and I don't know what exit code 127 means currently. I'm sure someone is going to tell me, hopefully, and maybe this can be figured out. If so, I will try to update you guys. Then there are a bunch of apps on Sailfish OS, and I didn't have the time to get into all of them yet. I now installed Sailfish X, which is this official Sailfish thing on an Xperia X I have, and I will try using that because it doesn't have the bugs the PinePhone has, and this is maybe will be a more pleasant experience maybe here and there. But Sailfish, oh no, please wake up again. Sailfish has this Storeman app store, which is openrepos.net, as you know, and it has this Contract app, which is for the German COVID exposure notification stuff. And it has a settings screen, and I will just try to perform this daily update to see if this app is running, because having an exposure notification enabled device would be a huge change and enable me to use the PinePhone comfortably as a daily driver, because, well, Germany may have not as many cases as other countries, but still the place where I live is in a way, I think, still the COVID capital. I'm not sure about the current numbers, but there is COVID out there, and I don't want to get it. and if I get it, I don't wanna give it to anybody else. So that's why I'm being careful here, and it says disabled, unfortunately, risk status low, and I don't know how I can enable it. Let's see if there's something here. Servers, no, that doesn't have anything to do with it. Can I tap this? No, I can't. Okay, it looks like there's no working exposure notification app for the PinePhone, even on Safer OS, and well, that's sad. But by the way, this contract app, maybe someone who knows more about this can port it to Kirigami or something, so that we could have this on other distributions. That would be really great. Now there's one more thing I need to show you, because I earlier showed you the commands to upgrade Safer OS. If you type devil-su in the terminal, you will be asked to enter a password, and you will try to enter your PIN, because that's how it works on the other PinePhone distributions usually, because it's sudo basically. But this is a root password, and you didn't set any, so what is it? And for that, you can go to the settings menu, to developer mode, and then just hit this ABC button here. Enter your PIN. I'm not going to share my root password here, and it will show something. If there is none, you need to hit the generate button once, but then you've got a short root password and can then try enabling Flatpak or updating the system. So yeah, that's Safefish. It's really smooth, even on the PinePhone, and that's great. This terminal keyboard is it's complete, but it's a bit tough to use. I think it's FingerTerm is the app that is called, and well, there are also some messages. I did not really get into all of this. I can briefly show you that incoming calls are working, at least they were before the update, so let's test this. Yeah, look at that. So swipe up for more options, and now I've answered that call. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? I don't know how to demo this properly, because I don't have a microphone to put to the earpiece here. But yeah, let's end that call, and well, that worked. Didn't work in an earlier demo, so that's great. And I think just try it out and see how well it works for you. You can add a whole load of accounts. It supports CalDev and CardDev, and does so on the PinePhone too. So this might be something that is definitely among the better distributions. And if you need your stuff to be smooth, it's also one to watch. The camera, because I know someone will ask me about that, doesn't work though. But then again, the PinePhone camera, it has 5 megapixels. I mean, come on. If you want that working really well, you have to go with Arch Linux ARM, I think. So yeah, thank you for watching. Please maybe have a look at my blog. It's at linmob. It's not at linmob. It's linmob.net. You can follow my Twitter, which is at linmobblog. Trying to load it here. No, hit someone else. That's not me. And well, just also I'm on Mastodon at linmob. At fostodon.org, and I just published, by the way, a weekly update, which is what I always post every week for the 16th time today. And then I've got this app list, which I would like you to have a look at as well. It is not for Safefish OS apps, because Safefish has open repos and the Yola store, so that's enough, I think. For app directories, no, but this is for Plasma Mobile and all those Fosh featuring operating systems. to have an idea which Linux desktop apps or apps specifically made for mobile out there, and maybe get an idea how well they work. You can contribute to that. I would very much like that. But now, thank you for watching and goodbye. Have a great week.